Now bonjour guys, welcome back to the channel, another Swiss 001 video. Now today we are back in the south of France, which is why I said bonjour, which has nothing to do with what we're here for actually. Yeah, today we are going to talk about the DHC6 Twin Otter again. You know, by the very interesting manufacturer of De Havilland Canada. Yeah, they make very interesting planes, just like this one, the Twin Otter. Yeah, this is probably one of the most famous stall planes out there. And you know, stall plane stands for short take off or landing or something like that, which very, very well explains the actual use of that plane. Yeah, this plane, it can stop on very short runways and take off on them, right? That makes sense, yeah. This plane, it doesn't need a long runway at all, which is perfect for our first airport here. This is Le Mans Airport, again in the south of France. Very nice one, actually one of my most favorite airports to visit. So let's go ahead and get this plane landed here. Again, this should not be any issue at all. There's even like bigger jets operating here sometimes and crashing here sometimes, because this is actually a very short runway, 1200 meters, really not a lot, but no problem again for our Twin Otter. All right, now a landing. This time we can even afford to do a smooth landing. You know, this plane is not particularly used to doing smooth landings, because you don't usually do smooth landings on this plane, and we didn't this time around either. 700 feet per minute of a landing speed was really not good. I mean, yeah, I was kind of busy talking while doing this landing, so, you know. That was totally fine. 700 feet per minute is something this plane can totally do, as we can tell. Yeah, this is probably one of the most extreme planes anyway, just, you know, aside from the fact that it can also land on short runways. It can operate at very extreme conditions as well, which it does in real life. I have to mention it again, this is an actual like airliner. As you can see, this is an actual cabin. It can seat quite a few people. Yeah, depending on the configuration, this can seat up to 20 people actually, which is quite crazy. And we are taxiing through grass right now. So let's see to what kind of places this plane can bring 20 people. For example, a place that is very often seen is obviously the Caribbean. This plane is perfect for island hopping. Let's maybe go to Saint Barthélemy then. Another French island, I think. Yeah, we're keeping things French here. All right, now we'll come to the Caribbean. And here we have St. Bartholomew's runway popping up. Yeah, this one is only 600 meters long, half as long as Le Mans runway. But not even half the problem of Le Mans runway either for the Twin Otter. No worries at all. As we'll see later, this plane can stop at even very, very much shorter distances and runways. I think we're actually gonna have to go for helipads later on. Yeah, you see where I'm trying to go with this video. I'm trying to find the shortest distance that this plane can actually stop at. All right, we're landing on the runway 10 side. You know, we have a hill right in front of that one. Very, very interesting approach indeed. Let's go ahead and get this plane touched down and stopped more specifically. Oh, very, very hard landing. Again, 876 feet per minute, but no worries at all for this stop at all, really. We stopped within a second or two, to be quite exact. All right, let's see how that went. Oh, there's actual people down there. Idiots. All right, let's see. Boom, very hard landing, but again, not that particularly an issue for this one. And a very, very, very quick stop. No worries at all. Obviously, this plane does need a long runway for takeoffs as well. No worries at all. Here we go, we can already take off. Yeah, this plane can perfectly fly at around 60 knots already. You know, a speed a Cessna 172 or something would fly at. But compared to the Cessna 172, this plane can seat a few more people than four. Yeah, we're at 20. That's really good. Let's maybe go to another place. Let's maybe go to the mountains, because obviously this plane is used in the mountains as well a lot. For example, Lukla in the Nepalese mountains. Probably one of the most dangerous airports out there, because not only do we have a 500 meter long runway, but also, you know, mountains. For that one, we're going to use the Tundra edition of the DHC6 Twin Otter. This one can fly at very, very low temperatures and harsh conditions as well, which is perfect for the Nepalese mountains. So let's go ahead. All right, welcome to the mountains. As you can see, this is a little bit of a harsher thing here. The barely 500 meter long runway of Lukla is already popping up behind this mountain. Here we go. Now we have it in sight. Let's go ahead and get this plane landed on that very short runway, which again will not be any issue at all, even though we're coming in very, very high, but again, no problem. Here we go. Pretty hard landing, but no worries for the Twin Otter. And there we go, a very, very quick stop. Now, this plane, it is very tolerant as well when it comes to bad landings. We're able to do them anyhow. We're able to do even imperfect landings, even at places like this, which is something that you would never be able to do in something like a Cessna or something. This plane is far more powerful. I think we can even take off like this from this side, which is facing the mountain, which is obviously how you would normally not take off, but no problem for the Twin Otter, right? Here we go. We have already reached some speed. Oh, this might actually get a little closer than all right. This, of course, did not happen. I mean, obviously, there's this very, very large slope here, making a takeoff not necessarily easier, you know, with the mountain facing side. So, whatever. We're gonna try even some shorter runway now. Let's maybe return back to the Caribbean. Of course, we're gonna try Saba Airport with its 300-meter long runway, which is the shortest runway that this plane operates at, and also the shortest runway on this planet. You know, the shortest commercial runway, at least. Yeah, Wind Air, for example, flies to this place. So let's go ahead and select the Wind Air livery. Oh yeah, we have this very beautiful island just ahead of us. As you can tell, this is a very interesting island here with its mountain. This one actually belongs to the Netherlands. And a fun fact is that this mountain here is the highest mountains in the Netherlands. Actually, it's the highest elevation at all in the Netherlands. It's not in the Netherlands, but it's, you know, it belongs to the Netherlands. I think this mountain is actually like 800 meters tall, maybe even taller than that, which is a lot taller than any land of the Netherlands. So that's an interesting fun fact. What is even more interesting is obviously the runway that we've got right in front of us, 300 meters long. But as we'll see in a second, this will not be any issue for the Twin Otter either. Oh, wow, that was a really bad landing. I think that was actually a proper crash there. Okay. Well, something I tried doing was stopping as quickly as possible just to show what this aircraft can do. And I think I might have crashed this plane here kind of. Oh, that's really gone wrong. But, you know, a very extreme plane this is indeed. No worries at all. So we can even go shorter than that. So let me go to the shortest at all runway on this planet. For example, there's this very interesting airport called Skyline in Idaho, USA. 140 meters long. Let me just mention that is 400 feet, barely. I have already made a dedicated video to that. Is this plane happy with 140 meters of runway? Let's check it out. This now is actually a private airport. Someone built this airport with their own hands, which is something you can easily do in the US. You cannot easily do that here in Europe, for example. But in the US, you can build your own airport. And the manufacturer of this airport probably had the goal to end up in some kind of Wikipedia list, which, you know, it did. So, you know, that's the goal reached. Let's see. Alrighty, welcome to Idaho. Now, this is now a guessing game, kind of. Where is that damn runway? And it's actually ahead. Here we go, this very, very small grass strip. I mean, you know, there's always special people out there, and I do actually still have the scenery installed for Idaho. It doesn't look particularly good. Oh, no, it looks good. Well, it actually does look pretty good there. Yeah, this is literally not even an airport facility. This was probably just a lot of paperwork to do, and there we go. You've got an airstrip in your backyard. I mean, it would be cool if the person that made the airstrip actually went ahead and paved it, you know, with actual markings or something. That would be nice. Let's go ahead and get this plane landed here, which I think will not be any issue at all either. So, you know. Alrighty. Alright, a very, very hard landing, 1,100 feet per minute, but no issue for the Twin Otter. Wow, that was really good. No problem at all. Here we go. Very, very nice. Again, 140 meters of runway, and we still have a little bit left, so we know we can even go shorter than this. The question is now, of course, where do we go? Obviously, helipads. What is the biggest helipad that there is? Well, there aren't really any big helipads. Let's just go for a random one. What do we got? Special starts? Well, actually, there aren't really any helipads. So let's just see what we've got right in this area here. I've actually got an idea. Let's maybe go to the Alpine Mountains, you know, to Innsbruck Airport. That one has helipads indeed. 21 by 28 meters. Yeah, no, this will not work. I mean, we can try out. All right, now welcome to the Austrian mountains here in Innsbruck. Let's try getting this plane landed on one of its helipads, which is going to be an interesting operation. First, though, we have to actually find the helipad. Jesus Christ. I have zero idea where it's supposed to be. I think I do actually have it in sight, though. All right. All right, helipad is ahead. There we go. Oh, this is definitely not going to work out. This is the smallest helipad. Jesus Christ. Yeah. No, this did not work at all. We're gonna have to try like another way of finding out how much of a runway this plane needs. And that is Google. If you want to operate this plane as an airliner and fly to small runways, you're at least gonna want to need a 300 meter long runway for takeoff and landing, and we have crashed. God damn it. So interestingly enough, the airport of Sabah, you know, that one we checked out earlier, is really the shortest that this plane can actually go. So it's really pushing that to the limit. Again, around 1,000 feet or 320 meters is the legal limit that this one can do. I mean, we've seen that this plane can operate on smaller runways, but that's a whole other story. So that's the DHC-6 Twin Otter for you. So yeah, guys, thank you for watching today's video, and I'll see you tomorrow. As always, good night. Thank you.